Today on Animal Fact Files, we're discussing horny sponges. Their name has nothing to do with their sexual tendencies. Their lascivious name comes from their structure. These invertebrates contain a large amount of fibrous material called spongin. Spongin is similar in structure to keratin, which is what fingernails, hair, and ding ding ding, horns are made of. They're also sometimes referred to as the keratose sponges for this reason. There are currently around 550 described species of horny sponges, and some of these species should be familiar. Natural bath sponges are horny sponges. Keratose sponges have a unique structure. They don't have the needle-like spicules found in other sponge species, so it's not painful to touch and squeeze them. Some describe them as slimy feeling, while others remark that they're velvety to the touch. The fibrous skeleton of the horny sponges makes them tough and able to hold a lot of water, two features that make some species highly desirable to humans as implements for cleaning. These invertebrates are largely found in shallow waters around reefs, but they live worldwide, and some species reside more than a mile, 1,600 meters, below the ocean's surface. Like other sponges, horny sponges have pores throughout their boneless skeleton. Water containing oxygen, waste, and organic debris, which acts as food, passes through these pores due to tiny hair-like structures inside the sponge's body. These small cells, called collar cells, create a current that keeps the water circulating and moving into and out of the sponge. They're filter feeders. The collar cells trap bacteria, algae, planktonic animals, and other material to be digested by a different type of specialist cell. Typically, water and waste are pushed out through the larger pores in the sponge's skeleton. In the case of horny sponges, these larger holes are sometimes positioned on a raised section of the body, looking kind of like a small volcano on the sponge's surface. Although many of the natural bath sponges we see are sized to fit easily in the palm of a human's hand, horny sponges can get far larger. It's not unusual for them to reach more than a foot, 30 centimeters in diameter. These sponges may appear round and bulbous, but as is usual in the sponge world, they still form ambiguous and inconsistent shapes. What's more, when they're alive, they aren't the typical yellow we normally see. Horny sponges appear black, brown, blue, purple, and even red and orange while they're living. They're yellow when dead and sold as cleaning tools due to processing and bleaching. Humans are not the only threats to horny sponges. They're also eaten by fish, sea slugs, and sea stars. When young, they're at the mercy of any filter feeders nearby. Horny sponges produce both eggs and sperm, and these are released into the water column so that cross-fertilization can take place. The baby sponge hatches from an egg as a minuscule larva that floats around until it finds a good spot to settle, at which point it develops into a tiny adult sponge and starts growing. Horny sponges are sessile, like other sponges, so they don't move around once they've found a spot to stay, and they can live to be 50 years old. We're able to make these videos through support from Dad, SpikeSpiegel93, and the rest of our Patreon family. Join them to help the channel grow. Give a thumbs up if you learned something new today, and thanks for watching Animal Fact Files.